Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the some important characteristic features of the chordates. Okay, and we are going to discuss about the protochordates over here. That is the subphylum Urochordata and the subphylum Cephalochordata. Okay, so let's start with the chordates. Okay. So, phylum. Chordata, phylum Chordata. Okay, it has been. See, we have already discussed about the outline of phylum Chordata, as it has been divided into two main, three main subphylum. That is the subphylum Urochordata, subphylum Cephalochordata, and subphylum Vertebrata. Now, today we are going to discuss about the subphylum Urochordata and the subphylum Cephalochordata. Now let's see on what basis we can classify, okay, or on what basis we can understand the characteristic feature of subphylum Urochordata and subphylum Cephalochordata. So in early session also we have discussed about it. So the animals generally which are found under phylum Chordata, simply we can take an example of Urochordate or the Cephalochordates. Okay, these animals, they have solid, or they have dorsal solid notochord. They have dorsal solid notochord. The next, they have presence of the gill slits, okay. Then next, they have presence of tail, okay. Then they have dorsal hollow central nervous system. Okay, so these are the basic characteristic feature on what basis we are classifying the chordata into three subphylum, that is the subphylum Urochordata, Cephalochordata, and the Vertebrata. Now, to understand the basically the characteristic feature which are seen in case of all these three subphylums, we have to understand the this diagram. Okay, we have to understand this diagram. So I'll draw here, and on that basis we'll start further classification. Okay, so here, as you can see, I'm drawing a diagram of the animal or the larval stage of the animal, which is showing the presence of notochord, presence of gill slits, presence of tail, and presence of dorsal hollow central nervous system. So let's see here. So students, you can see the diagram, okay, which is also been see given in your textbook, NCERT textbook, okay. So you have to follow this diagram. So this part of the diagram is referred as the nerve cord. Okay. The next to that is the and this part will be the notochord. Okay, this part will be the notochord. Okay, then here so student, this is a larval stage or a larval form. Okay, in most of the chordates we can also discuss this, in urochordate we can also discuss this, in cephalochordate and also in vertebrates. Okay, so this is the basic structure which has been formed. Okay, now here at the anterior part that is next near to the head region, there will be presence of the mouth. Okay, now next to the mouth, this part refers to the pharynx. Okay, this is called pharynx, and this part is the pharyngeal gill slits. Okay, then here it is the post anal tail, because as the opening which consists to, here it is the mouth and it is the digestive system and it opens through the anus, so and which is located at the tail region, so we can call it as a post anal tail. Okay, post anal tail, and this entire part, it is the digestive system. Digestive tube. Okay, so and here the pharyngeal gill slits, they are paired. Okay, so you have the paired pharyngeal gill slits. So these are the basic characteristic feature which are found in the chordates. As I told you in the very beginning, that have the dorsal solid notochord. Okay, then they have the paired gill slits. They may have the tail, okay, and they have the solid, okay, hollow central nervous system, or here you can see the nerve cord. Okay, so this is the basic characteristic feature of the chordata. Okay, now let's start with the subphylum urochordata and let's see the general characteristic feature of the subphylum urochordata. Okay, as we have already discussed about very few points of the chordata in previous session, now today we are going to discuss in detail about the subphylum urochordata. Okay, I hope you are getting this, because this diagram is resembling all these characteristic features. Okay, so I'll rub this and we'll start with the subphylum urochordata. Okay, so the subphylum urochordata, okay, subphylum urochordata. Now let's see the general characteristic feature of the subphylum urochordata. Okay, so the urochordata, okay, what are the characteristic feature in the urochordata? Here notochord is present, notochord is present in larval stage, in larval stage. Okay, and that to be, and that to be in tail region, in tail region. So see here, as we have discussed the previous diagram, right? In that, that will be the resembling structure in case of urochordates, but the notochord is only located in the tail region, and that to be in the larval stage. As this urochordate, they grow up, the tail will be degenerated as it undergoes retrogressive metamorphosis. We know the metamorphosis, that is the development of larva into adult, right? So here, during the development of larva into adult, the tail will undergo degeneration, that is called retrogressive metamorphosis. Okay, so see, next, during retrogressive metamorphosis, during retrogressive metamorphosis, tail is lost, means the adults do not have the tail. Okay, so they don't have the notochord basically. Okay, yes. So during the retrogressive metamorphosis, tail is lost. So we know that the notochord, it is located in the tail region, in the in the larval forms. Okay, so what here, the tail, when it is absent, the notochord will also be diminished, or it will be not present at the adult stage. The next, the example that we are going to study in this is the Herdmania. Before we see the structure of Herdmania, I'll let you know some characteristic feature of the Herdmania. Okay, so the body is attached to substratum by foot. So it has a body, or a bulging body is there, and that bulging body consists of a foot which is always attached to the substratum. Okay, the next, the upper part of body, the upper part of body has two openings called siphons. And what are these two openings? See here, these two openings are responsible for showing the respiration, okay, as well as for transportation. So these two openings are branchial siphon, and second one is the arterial siphon, that means responsible for respiration as well as the transportation. The next, I'll write here, entire body is covered by a layer called tunic. Okay, called tunic. And so what? The subphylum Urochordata is also referred as the Tunicata. Okay. So why it is called tunic eta? As the entire body is covered by a layer, okay, that is called tunic. So what the organisms are also referred as the tunic eta. The next, they are hermaphrodite. Okay, they are hermaphrodite, but favors cross fertilization. Okay, as they are hermaphrodite, but they favor the cross fertilization. Why they favor the cross fertilization? See, in this type of animals, okay, they are hermaphrodite, means they consist of both the sexes within the same animal. But at the time of growth and development, the female gametes develop first. Okay, so that refers to the what type of event that is called the protogynous. Okay, so they are protogynous. That means the female gametes or the ovaries will develop first. As the ovaries will develop first, okay, so these ovaries, they are developing first before, means they are developing before the sperms, right? So what they will do, they will undergo cross fertilization with the other hydmania in which the male has been developed. Okay, so what, in this way they favor the cross fertilization. The next, we'll rub this and we'll continue further. Okay, so here you can note down the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, here 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I'm rubbing this. You can pause the video and note down the points. The next character, that is the ninth character, the development is indirect. Okay, so they undergo various different changes from the larval to the adult one. Okay, and the larva is called Ascidian tadpole larva. Ascidian tadpole larva. Okay, this is the name of the larva which is formed in the urochordata or the tunicata. The next, they are exclusively marine. That means they are only found in the marine water. Okay, so these are the few characteristic feature of the subphylum urochordata. Now let's see the diagram, okay, and let's understand all these characteristics that we have noted until now. So here, so such a diagram can be seen in case of example hardmania. Which is also referred as C squared. Okay, or it is also called as the C squared. So here, so you can see the upper part of the body consists of the two openings. Okay, this upper part of the body consists of the two openings, and these openings are called as the siphon. Okay, they are called as the siphons. Here also one opening is there. So what type of siphon? This is the branchial siphon. Okay, this is the branchial siphon. Branchial siphon, and this one is the atrial siphon. Atrial siphon. Okay, so the body is like this. The body or the upper part of the body or entire body, it is covered by a cover. Okay, or it is covered by a layer. That layer is called the tunic. The layer is called tunic. And so what they are referred as tunicata. This part of the body is foot, and this foot, it is attached to a solid substratum. Okay, so this is the example of the Hardmania. Okay, so I hope you are getting this. You can note down the point as well as you can draw the diagram. Okay, now next we are going to discuss about the subphylum Cephalochordata. So students, let's start with the another subphylum, that is subphylum Cephalochordata. Okay, which is under phylum Chordata. So that is the second one, subphylum Cephalochordata. Okay, so let's see the general characteristic feature of the subphylum Cephalochordata, and then we'll see the diagram or the one of the example and the diagram of that example. So what are the characteristic feature here? So the first character is the notochord. The notochord, okay, is present from anterior to posterior end of body. Okay, so as we can see, the cephalochordates are characterized by the presence of the notochord from the anterior to the posterior part of the body. Okay, the next, the central nervous system, that is called CNS, is not differentiated into brain and spinal cord. Okay, so here there is no development seen in case of central nervous system, as we know that central nervous system has two parts, that is the brain and another is the spinal cord. But here we cannot differentiate the brain and spinal cord in case of Cephalochordata, because see, when we are discussing about spinal cord, when the notochord will develop into the vertebral column, but here notochord is present from anterior to posterior end in cephalochordate throughout their life. Okay, so it is persistent in case of cephalochordates. So we cannot differentiate the brain and spinal cord separately. Okay, so here next, they are also called the blueprints of chordates, as they match all the characteristic features which are found in the chordate. So they are also considered as the blueprints of the phylum Chordata or the chordates, all chordates. Okay, the next example is Amphioxus. Okay. So, example is the amphioxus. Now, let's see what this amphioxus consists of. Okay. So, for that we have to draw the diagram of the amphioxus. Okay. We will draw here the diagram and we will understand the characteristic feature of the amphioxus. Now, the amphioxus, it is basically a fish like structure. Okay. It is fish like structure, I will tell you. So, here you can see at the anterior part of this animal there will be presence of rostrum. See, rostrum, the term we also use when we were classifying the phylum Arthropoda. Okay, in that we have discussed about Arcanida. In Arcanida we have seen the prawns. Okay, so in the prawns we have seen the rostrum, that is the extended part. Okay, so here the anterior part of the body of this amphioxus is referred as rostrum. Then at the ventral side there will be presence of mouth, and this mouth, it is surrounded by a bulging part. Okay, so here it is the mouth, and which is surrounded by a bulging part. See, this is the bulging part, and this bulging part consists of certain sensory organs onto it. Okay, so these are the sensory organs which are called as the cerci. So here it is the mouth, which is at anterior part. See, whatever I am discussing here, you have to note down all these points. Okay, so at anterior part there is a mouth which consists of a bulging part, and this bulging part consists of the small hair like structures. These are called oral cerci or oral cerci. Okay, this structure, this hair like structure, and this bulging part is referred as oral hood. Oral hood. Now, as I told you, the body of this animal, it is fish like. Okay, it is the fish like. Let's see. Okay, so here you can see the fish like body, it is there, and which consists of a dorsal, okay, solid notochord. There will be presence of a dorsal solid notochord. So in this diagram you can observe the presence of the notochord, that is from the anterior part to the posterior part. This part is the anterior part and this part is the posterior region. Okay, then this part is the tail part over here. Okay, and you can label this solid notochord. Solid notochord, that is from anterior to posterior region. Then it consists of the fins. It has the fins, that it has different fins at different regions. So it is the dorsal fin. Okay, it is the dorsal fin. Then next to that there will be a tail fin, that is called caudal fin. There will be formation of a caudal fin, fin. Okay, and there will be formation of a ventral fin, or there will be presence of a ventral fin. Okay, so here you can see this is the dorsal fin. Then It is the caudal, that is the tail, the region where tail is present. At that region, whatever fins are seen, these are called caudal, caudal fin. Okay, and this part is referred as the ventral fin. Ventral fin. Okay, then the entire body consists of, okay, it consists of it consists of the scales. The entire body consists of the scales onto it. Okay, so these are the some of the scale like structures, and the scale like structures are called the myotomes. Myotomes. And these myotomes consisting of the striated muscles. Striated muscles, which are also called as the skeletal muscle. And in the ventral part of the body, there will be presence of 26 pairs of gonads. There will be presence of 26 pairs of gonads. So I am drawing few, but they are 26 in pair. So these are the 26 pairs of gonads. Okay, there are 26 pairs of gonads, and here they will also have the pharyngeal gill slits. Okay, they will also have the pharyngeal gill slits. Okay, so these are the certain structures which are formed within this region, and this region is the pharynx region. Okay, so here you can see the example of the amphioxus. Okay, generally it is marine, and you can see the structure which consists of the anterior and posterior part. And anterior part, the part which is extended is called rostrum. The posterior part, okay, it consists of the tail region. Okay, this is the tail part, tail, or which is also referred as post anal tail. Now here, in case of this organism, you can see the presence of notochord from the anterior part to the posterior part. Okay, and in this organism we cannot see the further developments. Okay, we cannot see the further development, as this organism do not develop at all. Okay, so that is about the amphioxus, and these are the few structures. Okay, at the anterior part, mouth is present, which is at ventral region. The next to that is the hood like structure is there, or a bulging part is there, which is called oral hood. Then this oral hood consists of small filamentous structures called oral cirri. Okay, or these are the sensory organs. Then next, the body, it is covered by the scale like structures, or the repeated scale like structures. These are called as the myotomes, which are nothing but the striated muscles or the skeletal muscles. Then next, the end part of this, or the posterior part of the organism, consists of the tail. Okay, and the entire body is covered by the fins, so which consists of dorsal fin, then caudal fin, that is near the tail part, and the ventral fin. Okay, in the ventral region itself, At the anterior part, you can see the pharynx is present, which consists of pharyngeal gill slits and which consists of 26 pairs of gonads. So, this is about the subphylum Cephalochordata. I hope you have understood this. Now, we will discuss about the another subphylum Vertebrata in the next part. Thank you.